are three exits, including the lobby doors behind you and a stairwell on the stage to your right. We hope you enjoy the program.
Selections before we bring up the big band. This is a composition by Dr. Scott Cowan. This is a contrafact. A contrafact is when you take an existing set of chord changes and write a new melody on top of it. These are the chord changes to Back Home in Indiana or Donna Lee. I don't know which one you were thinking of when you wrote this one. Probably Donna Lee, I would bet. Yeah. It's called Neem, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
headbangers ball. That makes sense, right? A headbanger ball. Some influence from Carlo's youth, I imagine. We're going to continue with the piece by Matthew. This is one of his older pieces. It's from 1991. 98? Well, close enough. This is his piece called The Black Cat.
Thank you.
Matt Landy on guitar. Keith Hall on the drums. Carlos DeRosa on the bass. Yes. Jazz Orchestra, you can start to make the stage. We have a few remarks while you're coming on. So we're gonna move into the next portion of the program, which is Phil Nimmons' Atlantic Suite. Phil Nimmons is a Canadian composer. He's 100 years old, he's still going. And he's written 400 compositions. He's kind of like the Duke Ellington of Canada. And for those of you who don't know, I am Canadian. So this is a very patriotic moment for me. Canadians are not known for our patriotism, but we're pretty patriotic. Not so much as Americans, but we have a strong connection to the homeland, the Northland. And Phil Nimmons is a really important part of the jazz landscape in Canada. He's a member of the Order of Canada. The Order of Canada is kind of like being knighted in the United Kingdom. And this particular piece, the Atlantic Suite, won the first Juno Award. So the Junos are like our Grammy Awards. And this piece won the first Juno Award for the best jazz recording of that year. I believe it was 1977. And this record came out on a label called Sackville. So the next question you might have is, why are we playing this, besides the fact that I'm Canadian? Well, there's someone who is also very interested in Phil Nimmons' music, and that's our very own Larry Bell. Can we give Larry a round of applause, please? So, Larry is a very committed individual, and when he finds something that he likes, he zeroes right in on it, to the point where we were having discussion about some of this music, and I think we started out talking about Sackville Records, and he said, "Do you know Atlantic Street?" I was like, "Of course, all Canadian jazz musicians know Atlantic Street." He goes, "Oh, well, here's the score," and he handed me all the score and the parts. So immediately I said, "Well, we gotta do this, you know, we gotta do this piece." So that's one of the reasons why we're doing the piece for you this evening. It's a really interesting piece that goes through a lot of different peaks and valleys, and throughout the performance, members of the Western Jazz Collective are gonna join the University Jazz Orchestra as soloists. So we're gonna play this uninterrupted without any breaks. So good luck, fellas. See you at the end. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
If you enjoyed this evening's presentation, I think Lincoln Street is a lot of fun to play for you tonight. Thank you again so much.